Another frequently asked question is, Des, can you show us how to elasticate a top kit? So that's exactly what I'm gonna do now. I'm actually gonna elasticate a match top from a Superior pole. Now, obviously, every different top kit has a different bore size, and I know a Superior top kit will take up to sort of a number 7 to a number 9 Dura slip or a number 8 original slip, but I'm gonna put a number 5 in. I wanna be doing some silverfish fishing at the moment. That's what I'm gonna put through. There's the elastic, and then there's the connector. I personally love the original plastic connectors for when I'm fishing for silverfish. And I actually use them as well, anything up to like a number 8 elastic. I just think they're really, really simple to use. They're really, really easy. You know, you tie a loop in the end of your line, you put it on, and it's job done. But obviously that depends on yourself. Some people use plastic connectors, some people use Dacron connectors. But today, I'm using a plastic connector because that's what I do. I've got my match top here, and I've also already cut the pole bung in, which I've done a video previously about. So it goes in there. Obviously, I tell you and show you exactly how to fit that. It's all nice and easy. So let's take that out first. This is a brand new top kit, so it's all nice and dry. If I already had elastic in there, I would actually take the connector off the end, get the new elastic, and I would just tie that onto the old elastic and just pull the new elastic through, so there's no messing about with a diamond eyed threader. So, but obviously what you want to do first is put your connector on, because you end up pulling the whole lot through and you've got to then use a diamond eyed threader after. So let's take the elastic out. Now the first thing I'm going to do is actually put the connector on. So make sure it's nice and clean. My garage floor is pretty clean. I vacuumed it quite often. So I'm a bit OCD with my garage, even though it is in a bit of a mess, as you can probably see. But if you haven't, make sure you don't get any rubbish on there, like dust and things like that. Now in the connector itself, in the plastic connector, you get two little pieces. You get one which is longer and one which is shorter. And I always end up using the long one. So let's take that short one off of there. And if you start fishing with thicker elastics, you might end up having to use the long one anyway to actually cover the knot up. So that's why there's two different size caps in those micro connectors. So the first thing I do is put the cap on first, like that. So that just runs up the elastic, keep him out of the way. And obviously that's the piece that you then connect your line to. So that goes on second. Now there's always, you know, debates and stuff like that is what knots you do. Now, personally for me, when I'm using a plastic connector like that, there's no better than knot than just bringing it round like that and doing a single figure of 8. Like that. Now before you get it tight, what you've got to do is get your tag end and pull that. So I just use my teeth, you can wet it down a bit and yank it real quick like that. Don't be scared of it, because if you don't do it right the first time, because you're putting your connector on first, you've always got quite a bit of elastic. So always put your connector on first. If you do it afterwards and mess things up, you end up having the wrong elastic tension and you can't get away with it. If you put it on first, if you mess up, you can just do it again. And that is as simple as that. So I give that a proper good tug like that. And then what I do then is don't cut the tag end off just yet. Bring the cap down that comes over the top and push that on, and you'll hear it sort of click on. But I keep that tag end, I try and keep the elastic there. I clicked on there, look. And that's like double security for me. You might not be able to do it with heavier elastics if you use, I mean, obviously when I step up to 9s, 11s, 13s and so on, I like to use Dacron connectors for heavy elastic. But for this sort of elastic, I love these plastic connectors. They're really, really simple. And like I said, just push that over the top, get yourself a nice pair of scissors, and I'll just cut that off then. And for me, it's like a bit of double security. So I've got my little tag end there. Don't worry about it. It's nice and neat. And that's on perfect. And obviously what you do then to put your rig on, you just push that up, put your rig on, that comes back down and everything's secure. But that's my preferred elastic connector for this style of fishing. And like I said, if then you obviously get down to the other end, if you've already got elastic through there, then take the connector off, tie the new elastic to the old elastic and literally just pull the whole lot through. it just saves a lot of messing around. But obviously put your connector on first. But this is a brand new section. I've got a little bit of like protector on my garage floor. It's like a, and just knock that through. Once you get it going, once there's a bit of weight behind it, you can actually just follow it down through like that until you get to the connector. Obviously, if you put, like I said, put the connector on first, because I've done it several times. I've learned the hard way. This is why I'm showing you the easy way, is you end up getting like that and the whole lot goes down through. So there you go, that sits in there perfect. And then go down through the number two section. These have actually got like a cone section on there, which is brilliant to make your elastic run a bit smoother, which we all want. Let that down go through again. If it's wet, if your section's wet, where it's got damp and you've broke your elastic, you'll probably have to use a dynamite threader. But let's get that out of the way a minute. Get that somewhere safe. Like that. So now the elastic's running down through the whole section. Then you get your puller bung, which I've already cut, ready to go. Feed that down through. Again, if this was changing the elastic, I would literally just pull the whole lot down through the sections and out through the puller bung. So I wouldn't even have to mess about with this, but because this is a new section, just give the elastic a little bit of tension so it doesn't get caught up in the puller bung. Fit that in nice and level like that, and then that's it. So then, obviously, tension is a really important thing, and I get asked a lot. Let me just get out of the way a minute. Tension's a really important thing. Keep that little cap, you never know, you might use it for a light elastic some days. That's all down to what you're fishing with or what you're fishing for and your personal preference, really. I just like it, so it's what we call pingy. So I'm gonna do that now. Next thing I've got to do is get the elastic, which obviously we need something that stops the elastic from going back up into the puller bung, which is, you can use different beads. This is what comes with the puller bung, so we'll use that because that's what it's designed for. So first things first is get that bead on. If the elastic's thin enough, that you can feed it through. I can't feed that through, so I use a dynamite threader. Oh, let's get that away a minute. So brilliant little thing, dynamite threaders. Obviously, I need to reverse this. The elastic, the connector's got off, it's like a cone shape again. So what you want to do is put it through the thick end to the thin end. So when you put your elastic through, it's reverse of what that is. So connect that up to your, to that, pull that through. And I've got tangled up in me. That's not a very good thing for a dynamite threader. It's a bit tangled up, but there you go. You can see the state of my garage. It's probably not how you all think it is. And then once you've got that connector on, you can then sort of think, that's a nice pingy bit of elastic. So number five, obviously we're fishing for little fish. That's about right, I would say. And then just grab that and try and do a real big knot. You want it quite big. So you can go around twice, little bit of lick, and you can always do another double knot over the top of that. Just make it quite big, because obviously it's got to stop going through that bush. As long as it's big enough to stop the elastic going through, cut your tag ends off like that. So that's there, all nice and secure, nice and neat. The puller bung is lovely and straight in there, so it's going to be a lot easier to actually put your number three on to feed it on. Let me just turn this top kit round. And I'll show you the connector end. Like that. That's beautiful. So that's what I call pingy, and that's lovely. I mean, if you were fishing for roach and skimmers, and then I do exactly the same process, obviously with my heavier elastics, but I'll just feed it through out the side of the puller bung. Sorry, outside of the roller puller bung. Put your connector on exactly the same. Obviously, I'll probably have Dacrons on them elastics. But there you go. That's the way to do a match top with light elastics.